welcome to a temporary and a little bit different space. Nevertheless, this is our Hatha yoga class with little extras. And to begin with today, I suggest to have, if you have a blanket, it's always useful for head cushioning and warmth. And I have prepared two blocks. These are not essential and can easily be replaced by cushions and other little things that you might have at home. We'll begin lying down on the backs today. And I'd ask you to perhaps take your cushions or blocks with you as you lie down on the mat. They're only there to support you, so again, not an essential part of this practice. As you might choose to lie down, stepping your feet onto the ground with your knees bent. And if this is where you're at today, please just remain here. You might choose to let the knees roll out to the sides and touch the soles of the feet together. Now, my hips are a little bit tight, and if I would now feel additionally something in the back, or if that sensation is too strong, I will place the blocks or cushions underneath my legs or knees so to support myself. And with that, I can actually hold this position for a reasonable length. So perhaps this is your choice, maybe none of that works for you. There's multiple reasons, knee issues, hip problems, lower back. If that is for you, please attempt the pose. If it isn't, legs out long or feet on the ground is a good idea. As you come to rest here, you might choose to place your hands right upon the space of the solar plexus area, which is just above the navel, but below the ribs. Let the elbows find a resting point. Wiggle your shoulders towards the ground. And make sure that your legs are either supported or in a reasonable position. You could then steady your gaze towards the ceiling directly above you, or you could choose to close your eyes. And then, first of all, arriving in this space. In the space that you built for yourselves. The space that your own body provides you with. Tapping into the sensations of the body now that you found a place for it. What's the first sensation that you might notice? Then move on to the second most dominant sensation you can feel. And maybe then the third as well. Perhaps reflecting back onto the first spot that you identified as sensational and noticing whether it's still as dominant as it was before. As you play with the sensations in the body, in your mind, notice the mind's abilities to be guided into sensations and also maybe choosing to wander away from that observation. Everything, even in our bodies, in our minds, and even in the emotional states, is ever changing. We can't hold on to anything. Everything just moves and changes. So finding these examples within yourself while you're resting here may be a good information for a physical practice today. Begin now to increase your breath into the hands, feeling your belly rising. When you breathe out, gently activating the abdomen as you draw it lightly inwards. On the in-breath, breathe into your hands. On the out-breath, hug the tummy gently inwards to encourage the out breath. Keep doing so for a few more breaths. And if you're a visual person, you might add the visualization that underneath your hands at the solar plexus, there's a yellow light, just like the sun. It rises as you breathe in, and it sets as you breathe out. Ever changing. Perhaps this light that you're breathing into spreads to the body, maybe even beyond. And if this way of breathing feels good for you, keep it up. But perhaps extend not just the belly, but then also into your ribs and up to your collarbones. We're going to breathe out, activating again the abdomen. Then the ribs come in, then the upper chest releases. So the breath in is the same, but then extends further up through ribs into collarbones. The out breath is that encouragement of the abdomen inwards, then the ribs releasing, then the upper chest. Establishing this breath for a few more. Just breathing in and out. Perhaps you find a rhythm of your breath that is suitable for you to carry throughout the whole practice. Releasing your hands now from the solar plexus, let them fall out to the sides. Continue your breathing though. You might have the hands under the knees to guide the knees up. Maybe you're removing the blocks and placing them to the side of your mat. When you're ready, lifting your knees up over your chest and placing one hand onto each kneecap. Letting the fingertips point in the direction of your feet or toes. On the inhalation, extending the arms and moving the knees away from your body. On the out breath, put the elbows tucked in and draw the knees towards the chest. On the inhale, extending the arms to rock the knees away from you. On the out breath, drawing the knees into the chest. Let's continue that for a few more breaths. Keep the pace, the intensity of your breathing as you worked it out before. And as you breathe out, keep your elbows nice and close, similar to what we do when we lower to the floor, Chaturanga Dandasana. You might now choose to continue the same movement called Apanasana. Or you could choose on the inhale to let go of the knees, extend the legs to the ceiling, the arms maybe over the head to the floor. When you breathe out, the hands come back to the kneecaps, drawing the knees in towards the chest. So either arm extension or full arms overhead, legs up to ceiling. The same for each out breath, drawing the knees into the chest, elbows nice and close. Breath in. And out, still the same rhythm that is yours. If any of you feel like a strengthening of the core, you might extend the legs away from you rather than up to the ceiling, perhaps for only three more breaths. Then holding the knees into the chest, separating them lightly, and landing your feet down at about hip distance apart. As you plant your feet down at hip distance, let the toes point forward away from your body, and let the arms come to rest on the sides of the body, the palms of the hands touching the floor. Your gaze remains up toward the ceiling, and with the in-breath, slowly tilt the pelvis so your back is pressing against the mat. On the out-breath, squeeze into your buttocks muscles and lift the hips up for a bridge pose. On the inhale, draw your tailbone up to your knees. On the out-breath, rolling the spine back down, vertebra at a time, releasing to the mat. Inhale, pelvic tilt, spine flat. Exhale, squeeze your bottom up. Inhale, the tail to knees. Exhale, rolling the spine back to the floor. Do that in your own rhythm. Each in-breath is just a tilt. The out-breath is a lift. The inhale is a lengthening of tail to knees. And the out-breath to roll the spine back down. Repeating for three more, but holding. And the last round, the bridge posture. Whenever you find the hold of the bridge, keep drawing your tailbone up towards the backs of the knees. Perhaps you can feel that extra extension over the front body. Your arms can stay rested as they are, or you might walk the shoulders under and interlace the hands behind your back, letting the arms rest on the floor. The gaze might still be upward, or you could have your eyes closed, feeling into the strength and the support of the feet, the legs, the glutes, and even the shoulders and the arms. Can you breathe smoothly and reasonably deeply despite the back bend? Then let your hands release from underneath if they've interlaced. Place the hands back flat onto the ground and take a very long outburst and see if you can roll down in slow motion, keeping some of the strength while you're releasing your back towards the floor. As your back finds the ground, let your feet wiggle apart to touch the edges of the mat, and the knees roll inwards. The arms might open back out to the sides. You could turn the palms upward for easier shoulder placement. You might then separate the knees and let the knees gently at first rock from side to side. If this feels good, you can increase the range of this movement. Also, feel free to place your feet differently if the wider stance isn't suitable for the hip rotation. If your neck is okay, you might even choose to bring the head into the movement, rolling to same or opposite side. Then allowing you to let your legs extend as you roll onto one side. On the one side, you might extend your arms over the head and let your legs extend out long towards the other side of the mat. You could then squeeze your bottom again and move your hips forward, the straight legs a little bit behind, the arms a little bit back, and then find a long stretch over the front of the body. Take a really deep breath, reach up to your fingers behind you and your toes behind you. And then on the outburst, just flopping down onto the back like jelly on a plate. Stepping the other foot down so you can roll over to the opposite sides, or if you're turning my back, extending the arms over the head, the toes back down, squeeze your bottom and see if your hips can move forward in that shape. Again, deep breaths over the front side of the body. And the same here, just flopping down onto the back like jelly on a plate. Stepping your feet back down into the ground and a hug of both knees in towards the chest. Give them a little squeeze. You might then choose to rock a bit from side to side, massaging across the back. And from this place, coming up towards a seated position, so your choice is to just roll up to the side, be supportive, or you might choose a few times to rock forward and back. Absolutely your choice. As you come up toward a seated position, I would use a block to sit upon. Please feel free to do it your way. As you come into a seat, opening perhaps the knees out towards the side if that works for you, or otherwise you might sit towards the heels and perhaps there's a block underneath you here as well. Placing the hands down upon your thighs or knees, and to open the shoulders, you're turning the palms of the hands upward. Give the shoulders a gentle shrug back, so the shoulder blades are coming down the back of the spine. And then let your tailbone drop gently towards the earth. Take a breath in and let your belly expand now. Feeling back into that space of the solar plexus when you breathe out and gently engage your abdomen. Deep breaths into the abdomen and a light drawing in on the exhale. Now that your breath is settling, your posture is tall, I will give you a mudra for the hands as a choice. Please don't attempt it right now. A little bit later, allow me to demonstrate first. So I would use both hands, thumbs, and place them just into the front of my ear to close the ear gently. I would then use both of my hands, index and middle finger, to cover my eyes. And I will use the remaining two fingers to close my mouth. It would look like this. If you don't feel this is suitable for you, please keep the hands resting. We will practice the Brahmari breaths, the humming bee breaths for a few rounds. I will count, and hopefully my voice is loud enough within your space so that even if you choose to bring the mudra into place to add to the resonation in the body, you will still hear me when we're finished. So let us begin with or without the mudra, a breath in together, and then we'll keep the humming rolling, inhaling to begin. Mm-hmm. Last round. And allow yourself to rest and observe. Bring eyes open. As you place the hands behind, step your feet up in front. Removing perhaps the block that you have underneath you or your sitting support. And coming with me into a standing position. You might choose to come to stand towards the short front edge of your mat, while I will face you here for easier practice. As you come to stand, allow the feet to be a comfortable hip distance apart. The outer edges of your feet are parallel. We begin this standing pose with the palms touching lightly together, Anjali Mudra in front of the chest. For the support of the stance, draw your inner heels toward each other. Feel how that tiny action on the ground helps you to stabilize, engage into the legs, the pelvic area, and even your abdominal. We will work with the light of the sun internally. As you breathe in, the sun is in your solar plexus. You're lifting the arms and opening them. Keep your support as you come into a standing back bend. The sun is rising right up into that space above you. Then bring the hands back to touch. Soften your knees and roll the spine on an outburst down into a forward fold. Let your arms relax, the head hang down, the shoulders be soft. And with the outburst uncurling, imagining the sun is rising from the base of your spine as you roll up all the way to the spine. And then on the in-breath, lifting the arms, palms might be touching, and drawing the hands back down in front of your chest. We'll repeat that. On the in-breath, feel the sun rising from solar plexus to heart, right up to the open arms of your back bend. Then touch the hands together, soften your knees, and roll down into a forward fold. Arms, head, shoulders hanging. On the outbreath, rolling from the lower back all the way up. Take that light with you. As you take an inhale, the arms are lifting. With the exhale, the hands are touching back down toward the heart center. Let's do that one more round. Breathe in as you let the sun lift and open into a back bend. On the outbreath, the knees are soft and the hands drawing down the midline as you release towards the floor, letting the body hang down. Once more, the sun is coming up all the way from the base of the spine, up the back as you breathe in to lift. And draw the hands back down in towards your heart space. Well, I will join you standing here at the short front edge of the mat. We will open the arms in the same way that we now greeted the sun for a round of sun salutations. So with the inhale, let the sun lift from your solar plexus right upward. On the outbreath, folding slowly forward, Uttanasana. Forward bend. For the inhale, fingertips to floor or shins as you lengthen the spine forward. On the outbreath, bring the hands down, step the right foot back. Maybe have the knee on the mat. Stepping the other foot back into a kneeling or a full plank position. On the exhale, keep your elbows close and lower down into the mat. Untuck the toes, leave the hands underneath the shoulders, tops of the feet pressing into the ground, and inhale to lift the head and the chest, perhaps the hands in the first round too. If you lifted your hands, actively draw the shoulder blades down the back. Next out, breath, release to the floor. On the inhale, come onto your hands and knees, and please feel free to let that be your base position. Or you could tuck the toes under and lift the knees, finding a downward facing dog. If you're especially in a down dog, start walking out your legs. If you're on all fours, start moving your body as well. Finding out about the little quirks and niggles that you might like to release. Then walking your feet towards the short front side edge of the mat, back to your forward bend. Think about the sun rising from the base of your spine as you're curling up on the elbows, lifting the arms, breathing in, and taking the hands back down to your heart space. Simply stand, inner heels drawing inwards, shoulders easy, and breath flowing right in from the abdomen to the top and out in the same way. Take another breath. Then let the sun lift again as you open the arms and the inhale. On the exhale, touch the hands, soften the knees and fold back down to the forward fold. On the inhale, half lift position. On the exhale, now stepping the left foot down the mat, maybe the knee onto the floor if you prefer. Then step the other foot back, plank or kneeling plank. The out breath to lower on or towards the mat now. For the inhale, you might choose a cobra, a floating cobra, an upward facing dog, whatever is yours. And breathe out either to roll over your toes or to lower to the mat. On the inhale, find all fours. Maybe there's a down dog in there for you. You might again choose to move this downward facing dog, perhaps a little bit on the spot. Maybe it's an all four stance that you are moving here. Then walking the feet towards the front of the mat. And again, uncurling on the elbows from the base of the spine. Imagine that light traveling up your back. And inhale to lift the arms, drawing the hands back down to heart space. Same here, inner heels drawing in, shoulders easy, and your breath is flowing. Lifting now the right knee and stepping the foot far down the mat. Lower the whole foot down towards the floor. So the stance here is with the left side toes facing to the short edge of the mat, the left knee bending over the ankle joint, and on the back foot, the heel is slightly turned out towards the other short side of the mat. The hips are opening towards the long side of the mat. So stands for a warrior two. You can adjust the widths of the stance to your personal needs. Maximum here, this thigh is parallel to the floor. Squeezing the feet lightly inwards. So you feel that lift coming from the inner thighs through the pelvis into your core. Keeping the gaze centered for now, let the arms just drift out softly to the sides. And you could even close the eyes if you can hold stability and start to flow through the arms, the shoulders, as well as the hands wrists and even the fingers. Exploring any flowing movement, no matter how high or low your arms might be, to notice how you are feeling in the upper body and the lower body is supporting it. Please then find a place for the arms, energetically fully extended towards the fingers, that resembles a warrior tree, but might be completely your arm position. Turning the gaze forward now. Notice if, as I set you free to bring the hands and arms into a certain position, whether you retreated to the textbook or your habits, or whether you really found a unique position that really suits. Taking a breath in now, as you extend the front leg, lift the arms, then releasing your arms and turning in towards the center. As the toes are turned out, allow a little sway movement here, and you could lean down into your thighs. You could also lean down towards the floor. You don't have to touch here, you could sway and move through the whole body. As you place the hands down now, turning now the right toes towards the short side of the mat, other side, and the left heel out to the opposite. Take your hands towards the right foot, and then place the right forearm up onto the middle of the thigh. From here, take an inhale and lift your left arm up it. My left arm is still challenged, so I will take an option and place it to the side of the waist instead. As you have your right forearm on the middle of your thigh, push it down into the thigh bone and then forward also towards the knee. As a result, if you're really pushing down and forward, your upper body will lift away from the thigh, and potentially the left shoulder rolls back a bit more. Your gaze could be towards the open space, or you could choose to look down. If you were to choose upward looking, tuck the chin. You might then wrap that upper arm behind the back as an option. Still stand strong on your feet, still pressing down and forward. You can hold here, or extend your lower arm and point it towards the mat. You could even then reach further down and find a bind behind your back. Not possible, come to any of the previous. No need to go there. If you were to go there, keep the top shoulder back. We'll take a breath in and out. And on the next inhale, opening both arms again. On the out, just swinging the arm down, framing the hands with the hand of the front foot, lifting the left heel. And now we step to the other side of the mat into a forward fold. On the out, rolling up through the spine, light can travel with you all the way up the back as you breathe in, lifting the arms. And the hands coming to join again, Anjali Mudra in front of the chest. Let shoulders be easy, inner heels draw inwards, and your breath move. Two deep, full breaths in and out of your nostrils. Then lifting the left knee, stepping the left foot far down the mat. Now it's the right toes facing again to the short edge, the left heel slightly out. The hips are pointing towards the long side of the mat and the right knee is bent over the ankle joint. As you keep your gaze here, let your arms float out again. Now you might be able to make assumptions, have expectations as you float again. The feet are drawing lightly inwards to support the stance, providing stirrup, stability, steadiness to you. and the upper body is flowing, and that is including the solar plexus area, we're helping with the ease, the sukha in this shape. Finding again your variation of it, maybe it looks a bit different on this side, and turning your gaze forward. Feet are still squeezing in. And as your gaze is steady now, assess your choices. Notice what feels right, and that is changing all the time. On the breath in, straighten the front leg, raise your arms. Coming the hands back down as you turn your feet to the corners of the mat. And again, you might lean down into the thighs, beginning to sway your body. You might move the whole body. You might come down towards the ground with these movements. Turning now your left toes towards a short side of the mat. The right heel on the other end to the other short side, and bring the hands towards the inside of your left foot. Placing the left forearm down onto the middle of your thigh and using it against the thigh as you take a breath in to lift the right arm. The same here, any arm lifts can be modified. You could rest that into the side of the waist. With the forearm resting on the middle of the thigh, press it down into the thigh bone and forward towards the knee, getting that extra lift and strength into the waistline. While you hold that pushing down and forward, choosing your gazing point, maybe to the front foot, maybe to the center, or upward with a subtle chin tuck to engage the neck. Keeping the activity into the thigh, as you might choose to take your upper arm and let that gently rest behind the back. Keeping the shoulder back, nothing else changing. Extra option is to release the forearm and point the fingertips down, or reach underneath the leg and attempt a bind. All just options, please make your choice. And no matter the choice, aim to keep your top shoulder back. Notice when you're taking it too far, you might collapse into the shell. On the next inhale, opening your arms out wide. On the exhale, swing the hand down, lift the right heel, and then step to the front into a forward fold. Let your out breath uncurl the spine, let the light rise all the way up your back. Take an inhale to lift the arms, and the hands landing again at heart center. You might close your eyes, come to a stand in a mountain, inner heels drawing lightly inwards as you stand here. Coming back to deep breathing. For the balance today, I would like to offer two variations. The first variation is hopefully doable. As you would release the arms, please don't do it with me now. Look at the options. There might be something in there for you. So first option is to raise the right heel and either stay here or take a hold of from the inside of the leg underneath. The other hand can go to the waist or rest behind the back. That is option number one. Option number two is to also raise the heel of the right foot, but lean down. The arm behind the back, the left one, the other one might reach under the leg. If you were holding a bind in the previous pose, this might be available for you. You could at any time release the bind and come to the same hold, holding underneath the thigh. So if you choose this variation, you would roll up slowly, finding a gazing point down towards the floor and lifting the knee with you as you come to stand. So let's make your personal choice and begin that practice. Right heel lifting, the knee is bending. Your choice just to take a hold or lean forward, attempt to bind or hold here for a challenge in the standing up. Find a steady gazing point on the floor and perhaps lifting the foot off the ground, taking the knee with you as you come to stand. Pointing the toes of the lifted leg down towards the floor actively and standing firmly on the other. Extra option here is to extend the leg out. It's a bird of paradise posture. Bending the knee again, landing the foot to the ground, releasing the arms. Try to do nothing, absolutely nothing, maybe drawing inner heels towards each other and observing how changes just happen. I know we have an urge here to adjust, to find balance. Sometimes balance will happen just by the automatic functioning of the body, or a change that arises. As you shift the weight over now, let's lift the left heel off the floor. Same here, if this is your shape, stand in it. You might pick up the leg, or you might choose to lean in. Other arm might rest behind on the side of the waist. And if you're leaning forward or taking the bind, look to the floor and slowly come to rise into a standing balance. As you're lifting the torso, pointing the toes of the lifted leg down towards the floor. Other hand in the waist or behind your back gently, finding a steady gazing point and standing more strongly on the standing leg. Option here as well to extend the leg out long. As you might bend the knee again, pointing the toes, and then slowly releasing. We'll practice that standing still one more time. As you land the foot, release the arms, palms might turn forward, inner heels might actively draw inward. You could choose to close the eyes or just find a steady gazing point in front of you. Hold and stand, observe the changes. Release of sensations happening naturally. The flow within the body adjusting itself. As we bring the hands to join again at heart center, take the sun from your solar plexus and lift it back up as you open the arms again, inhaling. Bringing the hands together, soften your knees and an out breath to fold back down towards the mat. Planting your knees and hands onto the floor. And extending now your right leg out towards the side. Turning your toes to face forward and walking the hands up to the knee, uncurling the spine here and taking a breath to raise the arms. Let the right arm now fall onto the extended leg and bend sideways over that leg. The same as in the side angle pose, the top shoulder is back. If the arm lifted isn't yours, bring it to the side of the waist instead. You might choose to look down or towards the open space. The hand resting on the extended leg is soft and gently sliding down. As you breathe in, roll your top arm and shoulder down. Turn the foot and lift the sole of the foot off the floor. You can swing the other leg gently behind. The hands can rest on the floor either side of the leg, or you might choose to use a block here as a support. Please float this foot, meaning we're pressing out through the ball of the foot while the toes are drawing back. Lengthening your spine over this leg on the inhale, and then surrendering towards half Hanuman as you breathe out, leaning toward the extended leg. Let the hands be supportive in this kneeling forward bend called Adha Hanumanasana. Keeping the foot actively floated is a good option because it engages the leg all around. Please feel free to play with this idea if you're curious. With the next in-breath, bend the knee, land the foot onto the ground, and walk your hands back forward, placing them down in preparation for all four stands. Bring the right knee onto the mat and take a big out-breath into an angry cat. Then release the spine back to neutral, extending the left leg out to the side. The same here, the toes are pointing forward. As you walk the hands up to the knee you're standing on and uncurling the spine. An in-breath to raise the arms. And now it's the left arm that falls onto the leg as you bend sideways. Same if your arm can be over the head, nice variation, or hand resting if your shoulder is challenged. Keeping the top shoulder back and bending sideways as you allow the hand on the leg to loosely slide down. You might choose to look downwards, forward, or a little chin tuck to look upward. Breathe. Delight in the hand sliding down like a gentle touch. Rolling down your arm and shoulder as you release the sole of the foot away from the mat. Swing the other foot a little bit behind you. With the foot at the front in a flexion, your left one, push out through the ball of the foot and draw your toes back, returning to floating. Be on the fingertips or on a block as you lengthen your spine forward, breathing in, and then begin to fold towards the extended leg. The hands can still be on a support, but let them come to rest as the upper body is leaning down into Adha Hanuman, the half monkey god stretch. Allowing yourself to be here for a few more breaths. As you next inhale, bend your left knee, place the foot back down, bring the hands back, ready for all four stands, and then the left knee lands onto the mat. Take an inhale as you might even lift tail and gaze, and out for an angry cat. Let's do two more of that, breathing into a light back bend, and out to round. Last one. Keep the roundedness and let the buttocks sink back towards the heels, curling in towards a child's pose as you might lightly sway to ease your body into the position. Then begin to uncurl the spine, walking hands up to thighs. We won't stay here, I'd ask you to sit to the side and extend the legs forward. Now you could have your blanket ready as a gentle support, very thin cushioning for the head. You might also have one of your blocks or sturdy cushions by the side. I like to align my legs with one short edge of the mat because that guarantees me I've got enough space behind to lie down. As you might choose to sit upright and lift your arms forward, turn the toes towards the ceiling, breathing. If you need support, bring the hands down to the floor. On the out, I start to roll the spine down. We're counting here to five. Four, three, two, one, and releasing onto the mat. As you find the positioning on the mat, bend both knees again, step your feet to the ground. Make sure you've got your block ready. Landing the feet at hip distance. Arms are by the sides, you're returning to the bridge, the palms touching the floor. On the in-breath, flatten the spine by pelvic tilt. On the out-breath, lightly squeeze your buttocks and raise the hips up. I suggest to use a block now. You can use that flat underneath your sacrum or halfway up, making sure that the block is resting on the last end of the spine rather than the three vertebrae. If you're using it halfway up, you might even keep your hands on the block. If you find it's supportive enough, you can release the arms. If it's possible in that support, let your arms be wide. The hips high and the feet can wiggle into very comfortable position. Not much work to do. Keeping your gaze upwards with eyes open or closed. Take a few deeper breaths and feel the belly rising and gently encourage it inwards as you breathe out. If you feel very supported, comfortable, and nourished, you could choose to stay here. You could also choose to change the height of the block. Maximum is halfway up now, or flat on the ground, an option. As you might take a hold of the block just to feel safe, lifting one foot up from the ground at a time, the knees starting to lift over the chest. If the block is in the right position, you might now extend your legs toward the ceiling. If you only remotely think that this block might tilt, please keep your hands there. If you find stability, you can open the arms again. As the feet are now the highest point, variation of a supported shoulder stand, keeping your gaze upwards, the shoulders light, but feeling supported on the hips, on the backs of the shoulder blades. You might have little movements here in the feet, squeezing toes, spreading them out, creating little movements in the feet, flexing, pointing, floating, circling. Nothing fast, and maybe keeping your gaze at this movement, observing while you're also aware of the sensations changing in the body. After a little while, you might have enough of the movement. Then let the feet come into a resting, lazily floating position. The knees ever so slightly soft or even bent a little bit more. You might steady your gaze again or close the eyes. Perhaps you're even aware of the downward flow within your body. Depending on the height of your block, you might reach back to hold on to the block before bending the knees softly towards the chest, landing one foot down after the other, placing the feet at a comfortable hip distance apart. Light squeeze to the bottom as you lift your hips up, remove the block and ever so slowly roll the spine down onto the floor. We've been holding this for some time. I suggest to open the feet back to mat distance and let the knees roll in for a constructive resting pose. Arms could be wide here, palms facing up. Shoulder blades might slide a little bit under. If you find a little movement beneficial, you might open your knees again and let them roll a little bit from side to side for a while. Same here, if the neck is happy, you could roll the head too. These movements now to find the ease back into the body, a sense of inner balance. Before, you could choose to have something underneath the knees, keep them this way and dropping in, or extending both legs out long. If you choose to extend the legs, please let them roll apart, getting out of touch. The toes rolling to opposite sides, so are your arms, shoulders grounded. Again, please steady your gaze or close the eyes, finding Shavasana, resting pose, corpse pose. As you find the stillness in your body, there's always the choice of keeping your focus on your breathing. Anything else is only optional. If you choose to follow my voice, it is about cleansing, nourishing, encouraging this energy center of the solar plexus that provides us with a lot of self-esteem, inner strength, and brings light and energy to the body. Breathing slowly and deeply. Feeling the contraction and expansion of the navel as you breathe in and out. Feel as though you're breathing in and out at the navel. Manipura should come. Fix your whole attention at the navel. Feel during inhalation that the breath is being drawn from the Manipura chakra trigger point in the spine through the navel and outward as the abdomen expands. Feel with the exhalation that the breath is being pushed inward through the navel to the Manipura chakra in the spine as the abdomen contracts. Then be attentive to this rhythmical process, just following it. You could now choose to silently add the mantra Om to each in and each out breath. On the in-breath, on the out-breath. Continuing with the movement of the breaths inward and outward, but now in synchrony with the Om. Feel the breath and the mantra piercing the navel or Manipura chakra and the Manipura chakra in the spine, solar plexus energy. Continue for just a little bit longer. Be attentive. Letting go of the mantras Om. Letting go of the navel focus. Letting go of the deeper breaths. Just letting the breaths drop into a natural rhythm. No particular focus, just being. You might now start lightly moving your body. The intensity of the breath is your choice. And perhaps only moving the body enough so that you find your way to a seated position. If suitable for you, joining the hands again in front of the heart space for Anjali Mudra. As we come to sit, let's lift this light up once again. As you breathe in, raise the arms and open. On the out breath, capture some of that light and draw it back down in front of your heart or into your heart center. As you lift your heart and your solar plexus up lightly toward your hands, and bow the head gently towards the hands, acknowledging the energies that you worked with, the kindness in the heart, as we extend lightly toward each other. Namaste.